Hello, welcome to another video. This time we are looking at how to make a video summarizer. We're going to be using a model called sshleifer, which we will be getting from Huggingface. So how to make a free video summarizer using Huggingface models. If you're not familiar with Huggingface, it's the equivalent of GitHub for models, transformers. A lot of this is new to me, but there's some great material on huggingface.co, and you can learn all about encoders, decoders, different models, and you've got summarization, translation, question answering, sentiment analysis, text generation, and NER, named entity recognition. You've got all of those, which you can do with Python by adding from transformers import pipeline. So let's actually look at what this does. As you can see, we've got a video on the right hand side, Kitco News, recorded at the Bitcoin 2023 conference. You can see there's a video summary here. But really, this is probably written before the interview, and it's not actually based on the contents of the interview. So what I've written using Streamlit and the model you just saw, so summarizer, which will take the video, the full video ID, where it is youtube.com/watch?v=, and then the unique ID. So if that wasn't there, we'd paste that in there, click get summary. And this is where the difference between free models and ChatGPT OpenAI comes in. So my laptop is not the quickest because money. There we go, there's the link. Get summary. Now you see it's running. Okay, so while all that's going on, I just want to quickly show you a diagram of how it's all working. We've got the YouTube transcript, which we extract as JSON, we pass out the text, and then we do pip install sentence-transformers, and then we do from transformers import pipeline. That's the key import. And then you can see we actually get the summary. And once this is finished, it will probably give us the same summary that we had before. So it is deterministic. It's not. I guess there's probably somewhere I could change the temperature, which might be a good idea just to get us some different results. Because you may not always like the first result you get. And there we go. Michael Saylor is an executive chairman and founder of MicroStrategy, prolific investor in Bitcoin, best-selling author, yeah, et cetera, et cetera. So how do we know that that is actually generated from the caption or the captions? So here is the video, here is the transcript. And it's just fetched that. And you can see prolific investor, so that's up there. If we wanted to, what else? There was marathon in there, wasn't there? So I kept marathon. And that's way down. That's way down, so that's. Yeah, that's on maybe line 300 or something. I can't tell you what line that is, but it's definitely quite a bit. Yeah, there it is. So it's quite a way down. The code. So I used YouTube Transcript API to get the transcript. I passed it. And then I loaded it back in once the Streamlit button was clicked. And then I ran it through the summarizer pipeline. So you've got pipeline. Line 16 is the bit to get your head around. So you've got summarization. That's kind of the, how should we say, it's like the verb. It's the action that you want to take. And model is the model you want to use. When you run it the first time, it will pull down the model locally. So all this is free. It's not costing anything, unlike ChatGPT. If you want me to just zoom in a bit on that, there we go. So that's the full code. So very simple code, really. Streamlit to provide the the graphical user interface. Get transcript, which is my function, which I've imported from there. And then we're doing st write, streamlit write, write the result to the screen. And that is about as simple as you can get, really, and that's all free. So what I was thinking was, if I was to run that on a series of, let's do something completely different. So what should we put in? Manchester Airport Live. And I did test one of these earlier and it got quite a quite an unfortunate result. I'm just going to try and find one where I know there's let's try this one, where I know there is subtitles, captions. So I thus started at 15 seconds. I think that's probably the, let's just get rid of that. So that's the actual standard link. Paste that link in there. Get a summary. So this was a aviation live stream on YouTube. Live streams can also have subtitles, captions, which are obviously added after the event. I think it's after the event. But this is 5 hours 46, so it's going to be extracting and parsing a large amount of comments, captions, subtitles, call it what you will. And once they've been parsed, they will be fed into the model. And any second now, we should get... if this is the one that I tested earlier, yeah, here we go. So, Bank Holiday Monday. It's Bank Holiday Monday, and on behalf of Mac Aviation Crew, a warm welcome to everyone watching, wherever you are in the world. Enjoy this 4K accident. So, this is not the fault of the model. And I'll get onto this in a second. So this is not the fault of the model. This is the fault of the YouTube subtitler. So let me just turn the sound down on that. And have we got captions on? Yeah. From Manchester, absolutely right. So today we can have some good starts to die, as you can see. I think because there's a slight accent, maybe it's there is some subtitles. Yeah, there we go. So you can see the subtitles on the screen. Okay, so we know that we've got some dubious translation there, shall we say. The other thing you can do is you could do, which one is it? There's another one that you can do, which kind of, it's a mask, it's a fill mask. So if there's questionable words in there, you can use something called a mask, a fill mask, which is something which I will be looking into in due course. So back to the code, quick summary, just to wrap it up here. The variables you can also change are with the summarizer is I think that's how many characters you pass in. So that's from the start to 4,000th character. Max length. I don't know if that's in words or if that's in, I'd need to look that up. So pipeline. So you import the pipeline from transformers. Line 3. Line 16, those are the two key lines. The rest is kind of just to make it work. So hopefully it's been interesting, giving you some ideas and shown that you do not have to use ChatGPT or OpenAI to do many, many things with AI. Although, even now, my laptop is struggling. So there we go. If you want to give me a thumbs up, help the algorithm, one day I might get lots of money from YouTube and then I can buy a nice microphone and a nice new shiny computer that will run really fast and I can do amazing videos. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.